Well, you'll remember Bill Nighy as the aging rocker from the hit 2003 smash hit comedy Love Actually. Now, 14 years later, the cast has reunited for a very worthy cause. And our very own Angela Bishop caught up with Bill to talk about his new film and the most anticipated reunion of 2017.
The thing about men who get sent away to war is that some of them don't come back at all.
There's so many of us. They'll never get us all out.
Mrs. Cole,
Kurt!
Where is she?
Could someone please get Mr. Hilliard out of Dunkirk?
Their Finest is such a gorgeous film.
Well, good. I'm pleased you liked it.
Tell me a little bit about how you would describe the actor you play.
Well, they were looking for someone to play a chronically self-absorbed, pompous actor in his declining years, and they came to me.
Just a dash of humour and then throw
her
a
rope. Excuse me.
Hello.
Hello.
Oh, certainly.
No, I wrote it.
Because it's a film about making a film, therefore I get to play the actor and I get to play the part he's playing in the film that we're making in the film that you're watching. And so I get to play drunken Uncle Frank.
Uncle Frank.
60s. Looks older.
We all have a part to play and defeat in here.
Not this part. It's a corpse role. He's dead before the end of Act 3.
They were very, very important, these films. They were made in order to keep people's spirits up, and they were designed to deliver certain information, how people could conduct themselves and keep themselves safe in wartime. But in the meantime, under ridiculously, stupidly hard conditions, they made some rather good films.
Mrs. Cole, we'll need someone to write the slop.
Slop?
Girl talk. Women's dialogue.
I thought it was a secretarial post.
The technical term for anything a woman said in a film amongst the male screenwriters was the slop or the nausea.
Oh my goodness.
And it wasn't that long ago.
There's a terrific line describing actors in it that really stuck with me, and I'll try to get it right. It was that actors, unless you review them or have intercourse with them, or unless you are actually at that time, they won't remember you.
Yeah, that's a little piece of non-actor revenge.
Right, OK, let's go.
I feel it in my fingers.
You recently got back into the Billy Mack part, your fabulous role from Love Actually, to help out with Red Nose Day. Now, we haven't actually seen the whole thing here yet because it's still been kept on ice for the United States, I understand.
Yeah.
But tell me a little bit about what it was like getting back with everyone and what might happen to Billy in the reunion.
Well, it was great, and no one hesitated because it's for comic relief, which is Richard Curtis's other great achievement, where he's literally saved millions and millions of lives, largely children. In England, they raised more money than they've ever raised before. And everyone's back, and Hugh Grant, Liam Neeson, Chiwetel Ejiofor, Andrew Lincoln, Keira Knightley, they're all, Colin Firth, Lucia, everybody came back, no one hesitated. And Richard's done a beautiful job of imagining what might have happened to those characters in the 14 years since we made the movie. But the big news is that I can still get into those trousers.
Well done.
Yeah, I know. It was a bit of a relief.
Best shag you ever had?
Britney Spears.
No, only kidding. She was rubbish.
How much part of your interaction with fans does Love Actually play a part? Is that one of the most mentioned?
Yeah, it's one of the most mentioned. I've got it kind of covered in the demographic sense, from 9 to 90, really. Men from 13 to 37, that's probably Shaun of the Dead or Hot Fuzz or any member, you know, the cameraman Morgan is nodding his head up and down. Pirates of the Caribbean, virtually everybody, those movies are beloved. And if they're my age, then it's Marigold Hotel.
You should marry that girl.
I want to.
I would imagine, actually, that I wouldn't have put you all on the same plane. Because just like putting the royals on the same plane, you've got to make sure the heir and the spare are on separate flights in case the worst happens. We could have lost too many valuable players.
In the first movie, I had to put Judi Dench on the back of a motorcycle, and I'm not famous for riding a motorcycle. In fact, I'd never ridden a motorcycle before, and before the shooting of that particular bit, I used to wake up every morning thinking, don't kill Judi Dench, because it could have so easily happened. I mean, I had to drive through rush hour in Jaipur with Judi Dench on the back. I mean, if you kill Judi Dench, you can't go home again.
Do you see yourself continuing acting forever and ever and ever?
Yeah, I'm sorry about this, but yes. I have no plans to. I'm in a job which is, fortunately, if you can remain upright, you can actually, continue to operate. In fact, you don't even have to remain upright. I could play those other parts. I could,
the lying down part.
Or this, sitting for the... steady, come on. Let's try the sitting ones first.